power. Okay. So what we studied in last chapter, we studied about Renaissance and Renaissance influence of Renaissance in art, architecture, literature, etc. And especially while discussing that chapter, I already mentioned that the conquering of Constantinople by Turks in the year 1453. It is very important, isn't it? After that, what happened? It dismantled the great relationship between Asia and Europe. Asia and Europe in the trade. So they tried to find out the new sea route to Asia. See, likewise, many foreign countries, especially European countries, they reach India. So who are the foreign countries or foreigners reaching India? For what purpose they reach it? Everything we are going to discuss in this chapter. Before that, let me go with the story of a pepper. Even the black gold has a story to tell. Friends and pepper, can I invite you to the Europe a few centuries ago? The rural folk in Europe would kill some of their cattle for meat and preserve it for following winter season. The heavy snowfall in the winter was not favorable for the grass to grow in the cattle field. Both the people and cattle faced a shortage of food during the season. The solution for this was to preserve cattle meat as a food for winter. Remember that there was neither electricity nor refrigerator of any kind during that time. So they found meat effective in preserving the meat and making it tastier. In short, I was inevitable for them. My friends, cardamom, cinnamon and ginger, all spices like ayam, were also loved by them. The tide is in search of us from the time immemorial. So, from this story, what you understood? It is very clear, the European countries, they are keen here for the spices. Which are the spices? Especially cardamom, cinnamon and ginger. What do you mean cardamom? Kurumalam, right? Cinnamon, kaavapattam. Ginger, you know that. Especially Europeans, they need these spices for preserving meat for their food in winter season. For that purpose, they came in Asia for in search of spices. So, we have in this chapter we have to study especially which foreigners they reached India first. That's all. The first foreigner reached India is Portuguese. Next one, Dutch. Later on, British, that is England. Then French. These are the four main foreigners. They reached India for the purpose of trade. Later on, after only they came here only for the purpose of trade. Later on, slowly they captured the places and they started to rule India. That is what the chapter from trade to power. They came only for the purpose of trade. Later on, they started to rule India. They become the administrator. They started to rule. That is, administration is carry on in India. So, first foreign country who reached India is Portugal. From Portugal to Calicut, Vasco da Gama, the rich Kerala in 1498, Kapa near Calicut. He approached the salmon for the trade, but he did not provide trading facilities to Vasco da Gama. So he left the Kano and gathered necessary goods and then returned to Portugal. So the first person, the first foreigner who is coming to Kerala as well as India is Vasco da Gama. He reached Kapa near Calicut, Calicut called So he appointed the Samurai of Calicut. Samurai means Samudri. Samurai of Calicut, but he rejected. And what he did, he went to the Samurai of Kannur, and the Samurai of Kannur has provided the essential trade facilities to Vasco da Gama. Later on, what has happened? He collected what all spices is required. After that, he left to Portugal. Then, following Vasco da Gama, is Almeida and Albuquerque was the two sailors who reached here for the purpose of trade. From Portuguese, it is very important. Three persons they came here for the purpose of trade. It is Vasco da Gama, Almeida, and Albuquerque. For what purpose? For the trade. In the next one, the important trade centers. See, throughout this chapter, we have to learn trade centers, which is very important. And Goa, Daman were the major important trade centers of Portuguese. So Portuguese, they are important. Two main trade centers is there. It is Goa and Daman. Next one, Portuguese were also known as Parangis. They were also known as Parangis. You can watch the movie Uhumi. It is a famous movie by our Malayalam actor Prithviraj. From that movie, it is very clear about the circumstances that is existed in that particular. It is very clear Vasco da Gama when he is reaching, how they are doing trade facilities with this our own rulers. Everything it is that way, especially this Kunyari Kaika. This movie center, which is the why I am taking the class, but if you are watching the movie, it will be very easy for you. Okay. So these are the, once again, from Portugal to Calicut, this Vasco da Gama, you reached Kerala via 1498 near Calicut, that is Kapar, and he approached the Samurai for trade facilities, but Samurai rejected. Later on, he went to Kannur and he collected the essential commodities and he left. And following Vasco da Gama, it is Almeida and Albuquerque was the next two sailors reaching India for the purpose of trade. Next one, Goa and Daman Thiu was the important trade centers of Portugal, and Portuguese were also known as Portuguese. Now, see, in our day-to-day life, we are using a lot of materials, vegetables we are using, what all things, everything has an influence of this Portuguese. So the contribution of Portuguese towards Indian history, as well as towards the Kerala history. What was the contribution of Portuguese? The contribution of Portuguese is, first of all, they constructed St. Angelo Fort at Kannur and toPower Fort in Thrissur. These are the two forts they constructed. The first one is St. Angelo's Fort and second one is toPower Fort. It is at Thrissur. Okay, these are the two important forts. For the what purpose they constructed fort? For the purpose of administration and to get this protection from enemies. Okay. Next one, next contribution. They introduced the agricultural crops like pineapple, guava, papaya, red chili, cashew, and tobacco. Everything is familiar to you, I think so. And because this tobacco, pugaya. Pineapple, you know, guava, pereca, papaya, red chili, cashew, and tobacco are the important agricultural crops introduced by Portuguese. This question is very, this point is very important. Why? Because in exam they will ask two types of questions. What are the contributions of Portuguese? What are the contributions of Portuguese towards agriculture of Kerala? This question is very, very important. Why? Because it is the contribution of Portuguese towards the field of agriculture. Next one, they widely use the printing machine. Next one, they developed that from Chowdhuranam. You might have seen in our school during our summer time, we have one item that is Chowdhuranam, and it is introduced by Portuguese. By seeing our own this art forms like Mohiniyattam, Kathakali, these Portuguese, they introduced their own art form, that is Chautukathakam. So these are the important contributions of Portuguese. The first one, they constructed St. Angelo's Fort at Kannur and Kottakkal Fort at Thrissur. And then they introduced the crops like pineapple, guava, papaya, red chili, cashew, and tobacco. And they used the printing machine and they introduced the art form Chautukathakam. Next, even though the Portuguese was very efficient in administration as well as they have all the facilities, but they couldn't able to establish power in India. The next one, why Portuguese is not able to establish trade centers in India? Why they were not able to establish power as well as trade centers in India? The reasons are, the first one, they did not have enough economic power. They don't have economic power. Economic power means in terms of money. Second one, they did not have enough military power. They don't have modern weapons. They faced resistance from native forces, especially this Kunyanimalika. Kunyanimalika, the admiral of Samul. Admiral means Padathalan. Padathalan means avarku vendi kollan nilkunna സൈന്യത്തിന് കൊണ്ടുപോകുന്ന ഒരു പോരാണ്. സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ ത്രീ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് റീസൺസ് വൈ പോർച്ചുഗീസ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ഏബിൾ ടു എസ്റ്റാബ്ലിഷ് പവർ ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ. ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ, ദേ ഡിഡ് നോട്ട് ഹാവ് ഇനഫ് എക്കണോമിക് പവർ. സെക്കൻഡ് വൺ, ദേ ഡിഡ് നോട്ട് ഹാവ് ഇനഫ് മിലിറ്ററി പവർ. തേർഡ് വൺ, ദേ ഫേസ്ഡ് റെസിസ്റ്റൻസ് ഫ്രം നേറ്റീവ് ഫോഴ്സസ് എസ്പെഷ്യലി കുഞ്ഞാലിമലൈക്ക. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ഓൾ അബൌട്ട് അവർ പോർച്ചുഗീസ്. I think it is clear. Next one, the Dutch. The next foreigner who reached India is Dutch. About Dutch, Kochi and Kollam were the chief trade centers of Dutch. Their important chief trade center is Kochi and Kollam. Next one, the book Portus Malabaratus was an important contribution from the side of Dutch towards the Kerala history. See, the book Portus Malabaratus is prepared by Van Reed with the help of E.P. Achilenbaidu. This book is prepared by Van Reed with the help of E.P. Achilenbaidu. Yeah? And this book is giving an information about the medical plans of Kerala. Variety medical plans. This book is giving a lot of information regarding the medical plans of Kerala. For what purpose it is using, that everything it is the detailed information is provided by the books, that is Portus Malabaratus. And the Dutch were also called Latins. Dutch were also called Latins. So this Dutch also, they were not able to establish their power in India. The important ever is Battle of Kulachal, India, 1741. Battle of Kulachal, this is very important question. So Dutch fought with Martha Ravana, the king of Agarpur. Following the dispute over right, Dutch were defeated in the Battle of Kulachal in 1741 and they lost their ground in India with this one. So Dutch, they faced the resistance from Martha Ravana. What is the problem behind it? It is due to the dispute in trade between Dutch and Marthadarama. The Battle of Kulachal took place in the year 1741. See, my dear children, the first important war that a foreigner is defeated by an Indian is this Battle of Kulachal. Marthadarama and between Marthadarama and Dutch, and in this war, Dutch were defeated. Dutch were defeated in front of Martha. Okay, Battle of Kulachal, India, 1740. But this is really important. So that's all regarding the Dutch. So Dutch, really few is the, that is Dutch important writers, it is Kochi and Kollam, and their contribution is Portus Malabaratus, It is prepared by manually with the help of ETHN by here, and it is regardless. It gives information about what medicine plants. And the important work regarding Dutch, why Dutch were not able to establish power in India because of collection law. It is between Dutch and Martha Varma. It took place in the year 1740, but finally Dutch were defeated. Okay. The next one is the advent of English. Throughout this chapter and next chapter, we are studying about the English East India Company. See, English East India Company formed in England in the year 1600 for trade in India and China. And Surat is the first trade center of English East India Company. And they established many other trade centers, that is Bombay, Mumbai, Calcutta, which is now known as Kolkata, Madras, now it is known as Chennai. So these are the important trade centers of English East India Company. Now we have to study this much only, but later on English East India Company, how they captured power and what are the methods they adopted to capture power, and we will discuss in the next class. And next important foreigners is French. French East India Company was established in the year 1664, and their important trade centers is Pondicherry, now it is known as Puducherry, Mahi and Calicut were the major trade centers of French, and Pondicherry was made their headquarters. So these all are about French. So now we discussed about two important foreigners, that is English, which is English East India Company was formed in the year 1600, and their important trade center is Surat. Apart from this Surat, they have many other trade centers too, that is Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, etc. The next foreigner who reached India is French. They established their company in the year 1664. And the important trade centers is Pondicherry and Mahi, and Pondicherry is their important headquarters. And from this chapter, you will have a lot of one-word question will be there for exam. And now is the time for homework. The first one, write a short note on arrival of Portuguese, that is entry of Vasco da Gama. Next one, what are the contribution of Portuguese? Next one, why Portuguese is not able to establish power in India? Next one, why the contribution of Dutch, especially of those Malabars? And explain the battle of Kutch. The next homework is, see, this is the homework. It is related to math. This is also very important, and it will be there for the exam. Now, the sixth, then under the map, prepare a list of different European trade centers based on the map given above. Can you identify the common features of these trade centers? See, all the trade centers, if you are checking, all the trade centers are located near to the sea. Near to the sea. Why it is located near to the sea? You can answer it. Okay. Next one. From this map, you have to write like this table you have to prepare. That is, first European countries, trade centers, present state. European countries means the first one, Portuguese. Portuguese established their important trade center is, for example, Goa. So, first you have to give heading Portuguese, trade center is Goa, and present state it is Goa. Like that, you have from this map, you have to prepare the important list trade centers, you have to write, and which presently trade centers are located in which state, and which is the European country, this trade centers is belongs to which European countries. That table you have to prepare. Okay, that's all for today. and we soon we will see in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.